One of the most distinctive features of the human brain is that its surface is covered with a complex pattern of grooves and ridges. These grooves and ridges are created by the folding of the outer layer of neural tissue, the cerebral cortex. The grooves are called sulci, and the ridges are called gyri. Particularly deep sulci are sometimes referred to as fissures. The folding of the cerebral cortex dramatically increases the surface area of the cortex, allowing more neurons to fit within the limited volume of the skull. While the pattern of sulci and gyri varies between individuals, certain sulci and gyri appear more consistently and serve as important landmarks of the cerebral cortex. In this video, I will discuss some of the most prominent sulci and gyri, although I should note that this will be an overview and won't cover all of the sulci and gyri found throughout the brain. Perhaps the most recognizable sulcus is the longitudinal fissure, the deep groove that runs along the midline of the brain and separates the left and right cerebral hemispheres. To examine some other major sulci and gyri, we'll start with a side or lateral view of the brain. One of the major landmarks of the lateral surface of the brain is the central sulcus, which separates the frontal lobe from the parietal lobe. Immediately in front of, or anterior to, the central sulcus is the precentral gyrus, which contains the primary motor cortex, an area of the brain that is essential for voluntary movement. The precentral gyrus extends to the precentral sulcus. The rest of the lateral surface of the frontal lobe is made up of three gyri, the superior, middle, and inferior frontal gyri. The superior frontal gyrus extends onto the medial surface of the brain. The superior and inferior frontal gyri are separated from the middle frontal gyrus by the superior and inferior frontal sulci, respectively. These three gyri make up a large portion of the prefrontal cortex, an area of the brain that's involved in a variety of important functions, but is especially well known for its contributions to higher cognition, such as planning, decision-making, and self-control. Just behind, or posterior to, the central sulcus is the postcentral gyrus. The postcentral gyrus is the location of the primary somatosensory cortex, an area of the brain that is involved with processing bodily sensations like touch and pain. The neurons in the primary somatosensory cortex are arranged in a somatotopic map, meaning that different regions of the cortex receive sensory input from specific parts of the body. The postcentral gyrus extends to the postcentral sulcus. A sulcus called the intraparietal sulcus reaches from the postcentral sulcus toward the occipital lobe. The intraparietal sulcus creates a division between two parietal regions, the superior and inferior parietal lobules. Both of these regions are involved with integrating sensory information to guide perception, attention, and interaction with the environment. The inferior parietal lobule also contributes to language processing, and itself is made up of two gyri, the supramarginal gyrus and the angular gyrus, each of which is involved with different aspects of language processing. The lateral sulcus, also known as the Sylvian fissure, forms a boundary between the temporal lobe, the frontal lobe, and part of the parietal lobe. The lateral surface of the temporal lobe is made up of the superior, middle, and inferior temporal gyri. These are separated from one another by the superior and inferior temporal sulci. The superior temporal gyrus often contains a very small portion of the primary auditory cortex, although the majority of the primary auditory area is found on separate gyri that extend into the lateral sulcus and are not visible on the lateral surface of the brain. The lateral surface of the occipital lobe is made up of a collection of gyri, sometimes simply referred to as the lateral occipital gyri. If we look at a medial view of the brain, we can see a prominent sulcus called the cingulate sulcus, which traces a path around the more central structures of the brain and acts as a demarcation line for what is described in some texts as a fifth lobe of the brain, the limbic lobe. The limbic lobe is a region of the brain that is important in emotions, motivated behavior, and memory, among other things. It can be considered part of the larger limbic system, which includes structures such as the hippocampus, amygdala, and others. The cingulate sulcus extends back to the subparietal sulcus, which often appears to be a continuation of the cingulate sulcus, but in many brains is a separate sulcus. Just below the cingulate sulcus is the cingulate gyrus, an important part of the brain thought to be involved in a variety of emotional, cognitive, and behavioral functions. A sulcus called the callosal sulcus separates the cingulate gyrus from the corpus callosum, a structure that connects the left and right cerebral hemispheres, enabling communication between them to occur. Just below the anterior, or front, end of the corpus callosum is a gyrus called the subcallosal gyrus. The parieto-occipital sulcus forms a boundary between the occipital and parietal lobes. The calcarine sulcus is found in the occipital lobe, and the primary visual cortex, the main area for the initial processing of visual information, is contained in the walls of the calcarine sulcus and in the cortex surrounding it. Just below the calcarine sulcus is a gyrus called the lingual gyrus, an area that is also involved with visual processing. Looking at the bottom, or inferior surface of the brain, you can see several other notable sulci and gyri. In the frontal lobe, there are a group of gyri that don't have a consistent appearance and are often simply called the orbital gyri. Adjacent to the orbital gyri is a gyrus called the gyrus rectus, and between the two is the olfactory sulcus. The olfactory bulb and tract, two important structures in the sense of smell, are found here. The orbital gyri and gyrus rectus are part of the orbital frontal cortex, a region of the prefrontal cortex that is involved in functions such as decision-making, reward processing, and emotional regulation, among other things. The parahippocampal gyrus lies immediately adjacent to and partially surrounds the hippocampus, and is thought to play a role in memory processes. And the occipitotemporal, or fusiform, gyrus extends from the temporal lobe toward the occipital lobe. It is thought to play a role in high-level visual processing, such as in the recognition of faces, objects, and written words. A sulcus called the collateral sulcus separates the fusiform gyrus from the parahippocampal gyrus. A sulcus called the transverse fissure separates the cerebellum from the rest of the brain. We have covered most of what are typically considered the major sulci and gyri of the brain. If you're interested in learning more about the function of some of the structures mentioned in this video, check out this video next.